When I was a pastor, I found that adults were dying to have settings where they could talk and not just listen.
Oh gosh, I think I'm like every minister in the world in that I wish more people would participate in it. Because when it works, it's so wonderful, but it's hard to get people to show up, and it's hard to find programs that work.
There are a couple things I love about Animate. One is I think that it occupies, for lack of a better word, a theological space that isn't being served very well right now, which is, I think, a large number of people that maybe don't consider themselves easily categorized theologically and need some space to be able to sort of breathe and grow but still have some sense of commitment to a center.
I think Animate will spark conversations for adults because we're not spoon-feeding them the answers.
So I think that's what is so great about the Animate series is that it's a lot of questions that will get people talking as opposed to just dumping information on them.
Oh, I thought it was absolutely genius that when we were putting these scripts together that Sparkhouse got all of the writers together around one table.
I think we all had this feeling that when we put all of our minds and imaginations and hearts together, something came out that was better than any of us could have done individually.
And in some ways, in our group, we were a model for what we hope happens in a great adult education series or class where you walk in one way and you leave changed because of the conversation that you've had with the people in the room.
I hope people begin to see the Christian faith a little differently, a faith that maybe has a little more hope to it and humor to it and is more accessible to more people.
Animate has the chance to create some very electric, carbonated space where people are bringing their lives and their questions and their faith together to see what explodes, what comes out of that.